Welcome back, everyone. In the last episode, we protected Diaz, and in between videos, accidentally missed a phone call, and it was just Diaz saying he wanted me to come work for him. You didn't miss anything, and now we have another cell phone call. So let's answer it.
Get to the payphone in Vice Point.
How mysterious. A strange voice called us and told us to meet him. In a world that is totally underwater. The Chase. The Chase has been spelled wrong, because Chase is normally spelled C-A-A-S-E-H. Chase.
Stupid horse! I'll chop your head off!
Who is this dickhead? Diaz is my favorite and least favorite. God, Tommy, we need to change your clothes, man. You're not on the golf course anymore.
Never trust a goddamn horse!
Yeah, why would you trust a horse? They can't even talk.
You work for me now.
Alright.
As I said, amigo, you work for me now.
I work
Shut up.
Whoa, dude, you're like 4 feet tall.
I don't know how much money I should
and
pay.
You're complaining to me about I could end your world. 100%. This movie has a lot of Scarface references. If you can't tell, this room is exactly like Tony Montana's from the movie. With the videos and the desk and the chair and everything. This is pretty much exactly. See, what it was when this game came out, Scarface, the video game, came out around the same time. Oh, it had to be around the same time, or else they couldn't really. I think it was something like that. Or it may have been. I'm thinking about The Godfather. Never mind. When The Godfather video game came out for the Xbox, Alright, Judas Priest, heck yeah. The Scarface movie, or Scarface video game came out. Yeah, that's right, that's better. And it's Tony, or Al Pacino gave all the rights to the Scarface movie rather than the Godfather movie, because he was in both. He was Michael Corleone in the Godfather movies, and he was Tony Montana in the Scarface, you know. Two very important main characters, like in the first Godfather movie, Michael wasn't the main character, but in the second and third, he was. And what had happened was he gave rights to the Scarface video game instead of Godfather. So they had to change the Godfather name, or not the name. They had to change the Godfather Michael Corleone, because Michael Corleone is in the Godfather video game, but they couldn't make it look like Al Pacino. They couldn't make his voice sound like him. They had to change him up completely. And, oh, there's the cat. Oh, dude, you're going down, man. You're going down. I'm gonna tickle you. I'm gonna find you and tickle your guts out. If you don't shoot me first. So, I really don't know. I read one time. I don't know if this game is making fun of the Scarface movie or. I don't know. I think it is kind of making fun of the movies. Or not making fun, just similarities. I do know that you don't need to get set on fire, because, you know, that'd be pretty bad. And there's an easy way and hard way to do this. Easy way is just stay really far behind them. Not far enough to lose them, but far enough to get out of the way of the bullets. Because, you know, they give you this piece of crap right here, which leaves you extremely vulnerable. It's good because you're a smaller target, but see, they shoot you. Just kind of keep, like, right here, you know. They'll never hit you from back here, and you'll never lose them. And you just kind of follow them to wherever they're going. And if it makes you feel better, you can go left and right. It really doesn't matter. As long as they don't get too far ahead, you'll be okay. Just kind of tap the gas every 20 seconds or so. Oh, unless something like that happens. Some idiot with a huge car doesn't know how to drive and just runs right into you. Then you get to play catch-up. So, a papa tomato, a mama tomato, and a baby tomato are walking down the street. The baby tomato starts falling behind, so the papa tomato goes back to get him, and he steps on him, and he says, ketchup. Pulp Fiction. Good movie. This mission takes long, because they don't know how to drive fast, they just know how to drive recklessly. I know that seems kind of like counterintuitive, or conflicting ideas, but, you know, you don't necessarily have to drive fast to drive reckless, you know what I mean? So, and then people get out of the cars, somebody just got shot, or did she hit him? Oh my gosh, murder in the street. Oh my god, everyone's dying!
face.
And I'm not causing it, so it's causing me emotional distress. Oh, he hit me. He actually hit me. So, KK Downing quit Judas Priest. I know that's old news, but he did. Glenn Tipton's still in it. I thought Glenn would have been the one to quit, but KK was the one that actually called the quits. But anyway, back to the Tony Montana thing. I'm going to circle this car because I got all the time in the world. Me personally, I think they just kind of made similarities between this game and Scarface. Because it's like out of respect for Scarface, so I think they did it. They didn't do it to make fun. He hit me again! That gun takes like 21 or 15, 16 damage, man. Oh my god, I gotta slow down. He's nailing me right now with those bullets. All it takes is one stray bullet, man. They get me within a mile with this sniper rifle and Hitler. Pack your bags, gentlemen. The war is over. Well, you know, when I watched Saving Private Ryan, I thought, oh yeah, just kill Hitler and everything will be fine. Well, it turns out you got to kill more people than Hitler. They unloaded that in. Oh, I'm really close. No, too close. I think I have to get close to them. I might have to drive like by them or up to them. Yeah, okay. Turns out he had to kill a lot more people, not just Hitler. What time are we up to? 25 minus a couple of minutes of in-betweenness. Nowhere to save my game right here. You get significantly a lot less money in this game than you do in GTA 3. Because I'm already up to like $100,000 in GTA 3 and I've only done like 4 or 5 missions. I mean, the hidden packages are thanks to that because I've got like 30 of them. But, I am so glad. I can't explain my excitement when I played GTA 4 and I was able to use the cab for transportation. I could not describe the level of happiness I had because I didn't have to do this anymore. Drive all the way to the mission and drive all the way back. Well, you know what I'm probably going to do? I'm probably just going to save the game and call it quits right now because that just... I don't know if we'll have time for another mission by the time I save the game and get to... I know I could cut, but I don't want to do that. Like, there's a lot of stuff that could happen between here and the save point. So I'm just going to keep rocking and rolling until I get back to the place. Oh my goodness! Dude, Tommy, you're living on the edge, man. We're not in the hot ring racer demolition derby thing yet. We're not doing that yet, Tommy. I don't know why you're trying to do some stunts right now. I know you had to make a few jumps to get some hidden packages, but you don't have to risk your life just to go save the game. That's kind of the opposite of why you're going to save the game. Oh. Imagine if there were save points in real life. It's like, oh, I went bankrupt? Well, I'll just revert to the last save and not make that choice. We'd have no need for insurance if there was save points in real life. Maybe someone should, start something like that. I gotta go get some armor before I do that. Know what I mean? Somebody should make a save point in real life. Well, guys, thanks for watching. Keep it real. Keep doing it is what it is you do. And I'm gonna go pop in GTA 3 and we're gonna record a couple of videos of that. Thanks for watching, guys. Keep it real. And peace.